Today we'll tell you about Mexico's healthcare system. It is divided into two sectors, a public and a private one. Within the public sector, we can find social security institutions and institutions and programs that care for the ones who lack social security. The private sector includes insurance companies and service providers that work in medical offices, private clinics, and private hospitals. Who are the beneficiaries? According to the fourth article of the Mexican Constitution, health protection is a right inherent to every citizen. In Mexico, there are three types of beneficiaries: salaried employees, jubilees and their families, self-employed individuals, workers of the informal sector, the unemployed, and people who are outside the work market and their families, and population with enough acquisitive power. How is the health sector regulated? The federal government, through the Secretaría de Salud, is in charge of strategic planning of the sector, the definition of priorities, coordination within the sector and with other sectors, the regulation of medical attention and sanitary regulation, and the evaluation of services and programs, among others. Talking further about the public sector in healthcare system, the sector embraces instances such as IMSS, ISSSTE, Pemex, CESA, SPS, SEDENA, and SEMAR. The first one, IMSS, has two different types of regimes, the mandatory and the voluntary one. Both apply only for those Mexicans that are active in the work market. The first regime covers maternity and illness insurance, work risks, disability, and pharmaceutical insurance for all its affiliates. The second regime is a voluntary agreement in order to receive some of the benefits that the organization offers. ISSSTE covers all Mexicans that are working or have worked for the government. This organization also offers the same benefits as IMSS first regime, but they also give a retirement compensation for its members. Pemex, SEDENA, and SEMAR offer similar benefits for its workers. The main difference resides on the quality of the medical care and the use of updated equipment. On the other hand, the Seguro Popular offers packages for the population, which include a variety of 260 medical interventions and its pharmaceutical insurance, or 18 high-cost medical interventions that include cancer and AIDS. As for the private sector, it has been growing for a few years now. Today, Mexico has a number of private chains, including Grupo Ángeles, Médica Sur, and Hospitales ABC, which have been expanding their offer and raising care standards across the country. One peculiarity of the Mexican private health care system is the proliferation of pharmacies with a doctor office along with them, a trend which has grown in recent years as a response to the growing demand for quick consultations. According to PwC Mexico, this modality represents 15% of the private care system. Talking about infrastructure, the Programa Nacional of de Infraestructura plans to build new settings, the investment of which 98.5% is public and 1.5% private, is directed for 87 health projects, including general and children's hospitals, among others. There is currently the purpose of increasing access, which means the private and public sector are willing to work together to improve the healthcare in Mexico. Now, let's have a look at some statistics. The OECD health statistics in 2014 show that the supply of health workers in Mexico has increased over the past decades, but remain low by OECD standards. The number of doctors per capita has risen substantially in Mexico since 2000, going up from 1.6 doctors per 1,000 population in 2000 to 2.2 in 2012, but still remains below the OECD average of 3.2. Also, as a result of greatly expanded health coverage for the poor and uninsured in Mexico because of the Seguro Popular, the public share of healthcare financing in Mexico has increased by around 10% to stand at 50% in 2012. However, this remains one of the lowest across OECD countries, where the average is 72%, and around half of all health spending in Mexico is paid directly by patients. Thank you. For further information, you can consult these sources.